My name's Dylan. I'm a PhD in physics dropout. Basically, Ant-Man Quantumania was coming out very soon, and I realized there's much more important things to do with my time. For example, calculating whether or not it's possible to shrink a human down to Ant-Man size. So that's what we're going to do today. I'm going to work out if it's even possible before this movie even comes out. So let's see what the math says, and if it's not possible, then you don't need to worry about going and seeing the movie. So in Ant-Man, the concept of shrinking a person is introduced through the idea that the empty space between the nuclei and the orbiting electrons that construct their body can be reduced, which would conserve the mass of a person but greatly reduce the space in which they occupy. So what we're actually doing in this video is not determining if it's possible to shrink someone down, but we're going to look at how practical it is. So we're going to assume that, you know, the process is possible, and we're going to look at the effects on, you know, some Ant-Man's environment. So the math is done. So Scott Lang himself, right, he stands about 6 feet tall, 1.8 meters, has a mass of about 190 pounds, 86 kilograms. And when he shrinks, he retains all of his mass and strength, which is kind of weird. So whilst the size to which he can shrink, it varies, we'll just take it to be about 12.7 millimeters, which means he's reduced to about 0.71% of his initial height. But remember, his mass is constant, but his reduced volume means he becomes way more dense. And so we'll assume he shrinks to about 0.71% of his initial dimensions. And that means his volume is going to be a factor of 3.58 times 10 to the negative 7 smaller as well. So the typical area of a human foot is between 73 and 113 square centimeters, right? So we shall take about 100 centimeters squared, just for simplicity. So by doubling it, we can actually estimate that the area Scott applies his weight to is about 200 square centimeters, 0.02 meters squared. And then the pressure he applies to the ground can also be calculated using 2, right? P equals mg over A, where P is the pressure, where g is the gravitational field strength on Earth, just over here. There we go. A is the area the weight is being applied. And let's also calculate the effects his small size would have on his vision. We can estimate basically the minimum angular resolution of an aperture, you know, the pupil of the eye, which is given by the Rayleigh criterion, where theta is going to be the angular resolution and lambda is going to be the wavelength of the light and D is the diameter of the aperture. So let's get into the results. So using 1, Scott's initial density is going to be about 1300 kilograms per meters cubed. And when he shrunk, it becomes about a lot higher, okay? So it's about 3.64 times 10 to the 9 kilograms per meters cubed. So his new density is now multiple orders of magnitude greater than anything we encounter on Earth, with basically the most dense metals only slightly exceeding 20,000 kilograms per meters cubed. And that's 3.64 times 10 to the 9. So not only is his density pretty large, but the pressure his shrunken feet will apply to whatever he's standing on is also going to be pretty large. So, you know, using 2 up here, you can calculate that the full-size Scott exerts about 42,000 newtons per meter squared, right? And then when he shrinks, and you assume that his feet shrink by 0.71% as well, the pressure he exerts when shrunk is about 8.4 times 10 to the 8 newtons per meter squared. This again is much larger than any pressure a human could normally exert and would be pretty impractical because his legs would be applying more pressure than a high power water jet. Looking that up, they apply about 6.2 bar, which is 620,000 newtons per meter squared. And, you know, we just calculated it was to the power of 8, which is 100 million. So that means he would probably find himself sinking into the ground or breaking everything he stands on. Basically, his enormous weight compared to the things around him are going to make it impossible for him to ride an ant, as we saw in the show. It would be similar to him applying 844 newtons onto the ant's back, which would obviously kill it. This video is brought to you by me. This is actually why I've dropped out of the PhD in physics, to create this, the world's first consumer post-quantum VPN. So please come have a read, come check it out. I'm really proud of it. We're doing constant work on it. There's a free trial for 7 days, heaps of cool stuff. You should definitely come have a read. It's going to be really important going forward. And this is what the app itself looks like when you load it up on a Mac, Windows, or Linux. So normal VPNs don't currently have post-quantum cryptography, which means they actually can't protect you from powerful quantum computers. Whilst they don't exist, it is going to be a problem because they will be able to capture now, decrypt later attacks, which means, you know, if we have them in a few years, hackers could be stealing VPN encrypted data right now to decrypt in like 5 to 10 years. So it's going to be a big problem. You should definitely come have a read. And it would mean the world to me if you could come test it out, have a play, let me know what you think of it. Also creating an AI project, which I'm about to launch, called AI My Interior. So come have a look in the description. There's a website. You can have a quick sneak peek. And if you put your email in, if you want to be notified when I release that one, which will be really soon. And let's get back to the video. So what we have just calculated there, my friends, is that Ant-Man is actually, in fact, the strongest Avenger by a lot. Finally, let's look at the vision. So if you take the diameter of the pupil to be about 3 millimeters and the wavelength of light to be about 0.55 micrometers, using 3, this one up here, the angular resolution of a human eye is about 2.24 times 10 to the negative 4 radians. Okay, so if Scott's pupil now has a diameter of 0.71% of 3 millimeters, his minimum angular resolution would become 0.0315 radians. And so through basic trigonometry, it can be deduced that his eye could not resolve two objects that were 15 centimeters apart if they were only 5 meters away from him. In conclusion, whilst at first consideration, the ability to shrink oneself and retain their mass sounds rather useful, as we have shown, the practicality of such an ability is rather limited because you'd be constantly exerting close to 10 to the 9 newtons per meter squared of pressure onto anything you touch. And, you know, the estimates we've calculated demonstrate the enormous effect shrinking would have on density and ground pressure. Not only that, but it's going to be hard for him to get around because his increased minimum angular resolution of this is going to make it pretty disorientating for him. So, yeah, very impractical, but we have confirmed that Ant-Man is the strongest Avenger. Confirmed. Set in stone. I don't know if it's actually possible to shrink someone down to that size. So rest easy. You can go see Ant-Man, Quantumania, and not be too worried about how unrealistic it is. And you now know you'll be watching the strongest Avenger. Confirmed. Set in stone.